Hi there, this is Flint from Warpath, and you're listening to Dave Softee's Metal Meltdown on Metal Messiah Radio.
Alrighty, here we go, Metal Maniacs. Please help me welcome to Metal Messiah Radio, hailing from Hamburg, Germany, from Massacre Records Thrasher's Warpath. Please welcome guitarist Captain Flint.
Hi there, what's up?
Welcome to the Metal Meltdown, Flint. Thank you for taking the time to be here.
You're welcome.
How you doing out there tonight?
Yeah, I'm fine over here.
It is great to have you here so that we could talk about your upcoming Warpath release, Bullets for a Desert Session, set for a January 13th launch by Massacre Records.
That's right.
It's outstanding to have this new offering, as it's been about 20 years since the last release, Kill Your Enemy, back in 1996.
Yeah, that's right.
So where and what has happened with Warpath?
Yeah, it was like I've just joined a while ago. I wasn't in the band way back then.
Right.
I just joined before this record about 1 year ago. And I was always a fan of Warpath. And I knew the singer when I moved to Hamburg, got to know him here. And they reformed. For a bunch of live shows, actually, but things turned out that well that they decided to continue, and some personal problems occurred there, and the singer Dicker Weiss, he wanted to continue because it was so much fun, but the other guys didn't want to do it, so that's how we got in contact. We knew each other anyway, a little bit from concerts and from the bar and stuff like that. And yeah, he contacted me to ask me to join the band, and I said, "Yeah, sure, let's go." I was a sucker for the band anyway, so that decision had to be was quite easy to make.
Well, congratulations for joining Warpath. It was destiny, obviously.
Thank you.
Yeah, and please inform us who makes up the current lineup of Warpath.
That's Dicker Weiss on the vocals, and Sören on bass. And Norman on drums.
Thank you for telling us that. And as the tune goes, no one can kill us. So that, for me, is a great tune from Warpath, for Warpath, which I'm interested to know in what led to Warpath returning with this Killer Thrash offering and ultimately signing with Massacre. Because that 20-year gap leaves a lot of unanswered questions.
Yeah, that's right. It happened, we played a huge festival in southern Germany. It's called Bang Your Head Festival. And there was a guy from Massacre Records there, the owner actually. He saw us playing live. And yeah, he wanted to sign us right off the spot. He came to the backstage with a bunch of cold ones. And yeah, that's how it came together. Classic, so to say. We didn't send out any emails or whatever. We played the festival and he dug it. No one was leaving the hall, and yeah, he was interested, and so were we.
Wow, that's excellent. If all things would be that easy, what a better world it would be.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah, sometimes things just work out.
Yeah, I'm glad that it did for Warpath and yourself and everyone involved in Warpath. I'm very interested.
Thank you.
No, absolutely, my friend. I'm very interested to know more about the Bullets album. What studio was Bullets recorded in, and if you could tell us who was responsible for the mixing, the mastering, and the producing of Bullets?
Sure. The first part was recorded in, it's called Absurd Studios in Hamburg. It's run by, funny enough, the first original guitar player of Warpath. He's got a studio there, and I work with him together from time to time for other projects. And first part was recorded there, and from there we took it to Chameleon Studios, where Eike Friese, big shot here, he produced Deep Purple and Seeker and you name it, and we did the final mix there and mastering as well, and yeah, we are pretty satisfied with the sound. It kicks butt big time.
Yeah, absolutely. It sounds like classic Warpath from, was it nearly 28-30 years ago? The sound remains the same. It's a killer thrash offering, as I said. And a lot of Warpath tunes deal with killing or war or death. And I bring that up because the design of the CD art for Bullets, it looks like maybe there was a battle or something behind this cover. Could you tell us who designed this cover and if there is any symbolic meaning behind this art?
That's basically, it's too bad that Dick isn't here, our singer. It was basically his idea, and he worked together with a friend of mine who's a kick-ass designer. It goes a little bit in that direction because it's all destroyed and worn out old war machinery. It's all wrecked and stuff, and it's basically going into the direction that war can't be the answer for any kind of question. It can't be the solution. And it goes a little bit into that direction, that you sort of say great warfare thingies there, and they all run down, and it makes absolute no sense anymore. Yeah. And it's going a little bit into that direction. So we're not trying to glorify war in any case.
Yeah, I had a feeling that's what it was all about. Yeah, I thank you for going into detail about that. And where would you say would be the best place for fans to get a copy of Bullets when it does come out? Would it be on the Warpath home site? Would it be on Massacre Records site or at your Facebook? Where would you say would be the best place for the Warpath fans to get a copy of Bullets?
I would say head on to the Massacre homepage or our Facebook site. And all the links will be there. It will be available as a normal edition and a digipack with two live versions of new songs. And you find all the links on the Facebook page of ours and on the Massacre Records page as well.
Right, right. Now, besides the CD, I'm just wondering if Warpath has any other merch available or plans on having any merch available for the fans beyond the CD.
It's all in the making. We're hella busy to get shirts done and with different motifs and patches and you name it. The graphics have just been finalized, so we're in contact now with companies who can actually print it and stuff. There's tons of things to expect there. Yeah.
Very good. That's great news. I figured that, but I just wanted to make sure. And, you know, Warpath has been around a long time, and throughout the years, especially with the break that Warpath has had, the German Warpath, it seems like there have been other bands by the name Warpath coming and going. Yep. I think most of them have broken up or split, and now Warpath is back on the resurgence. But I'm very interested to know if during the years, even before your time, are you aware of any confusion that has been created among your fans about your Warpath and other Warpaths?
Not that I know. Not that I know, but it wasn't by my daily business until a year ago or so.
Right, right.
I just recognized there's still one. I heard used to be a band called Warpath from Chile, but they're not around anymore. And there's one from Ireland who are actually still around. No difficulties there. And if there would be, I think we're cool with that. And we're around longer anyway.
You are around. That's what I'm saying. Yeah, you've been around nearly 30 years with a 20-year absence, though. And I did have an interview with a different Warpath from the UK, like my first year here at Metal Messiah Radio. I think that was like 2008.
Okay, didn't know about that.
Yeah, yeah. I don't see them doing anything since 2008 as well. Flint, has Warpath got a tour lined up in support of Bullets? And if so, I would imagine so. Where will the band be performing and who will be joining you during these shows?
Yeah, that's all in the making as well. We're looking for some more bookers right now, actually. There's a couple of shows booked already.
In Germany?
Yeah, so a bunch of shows coming up. We're headlining the Masters of Kassel Festival, which is actually happening in Kassel. And in January, we got a bunch of shows. We're playing Rheine and Mannheim. And in February, there's something going on down south as well. And we're just confirmed for the Wacken Festival.
Very nice. I was just going to ask about Wacken. Yeah, being that you're there. Very good. That's great news. So when you have future news about future shows, make sure you contact me and Metal Messiah Radio. We'll be sure to share the word. That's what we do here.
Oh, that's cool.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Absolutely. And
would be great to stay the States as well, but we see what happens.
Yeah, we would love to see you performing here in the United States. So we wish you the best with that. Let's make it happen. You know, maybe Massacre has some info to help smooth that along. That would be awesome.
Sure, sure.
Yeah, absolutely.
Justin, I haven't been to New York. I've been to the West Coast. My ex-band, they're from San Francisco.
What was the name of your ex-band?
They're called Potential Threat, Bay Area Thrash. They lived over here in Germany for 5 years. We had a band together here.
I think I have a couple of albums from Potential Threat, actually.
They are fucking great.
Yeah.
I would be a fan of even if I wouldn't know them.
Right. It's good thrash as well. Yes, absolutely. And Flint, let's talk about videos. Does Warpath have an official YouTube channel?
Not yet, but we just finished filming our first video. I got audio and video production firm over here called Flint Productions.
Nice.
And we cooperated with one of my favorite Spanish directors. We shot the basic band sequences here in Hamburg, set up a green screen, shot the band there, and he's cutting and editing it. It's going to be an animated video, and he's editing it in Madrid, Spain, as we speak. And it should be released within the middle of January.
Very nice.
His name is Dani Moreno.
Dani Moreno.
Dani Moreno.
Very nice.
And I met him here on a festival, film festival, stayed in contact. It's like he's doing a B movie-ish kind of monster movies.
Nice. And, nice. That goes good with thrash metal.
Or humor quite well, and I think can't go wrong, I think.
Oh,
can't go wrong. We're definitely looking forward to that, and that's the first one.
And so are we.
Will be published.
So are we. And what track will this video be for?
Yeah, it was kind of easy to decide because we've got one track. It's called Reborn.
Yes.
And it's in your face, thrash, no compromise. And so will be the first one that will be made a video of.
That's perfect.
Reborn.
That is perfect because this is basically
the rebirth of
Warpath after a 20-year absence. So that's a great tune.
That's right. That's right. So it all makes sense.
It sure does. And Flint, would you like to talk about your gear? Talk about your guitars and what endorsements you may have?
Yeah, haven't got any endorsements so far. I would love to have them.
I'm surprised.
But getting new stuff that I was looking for years. I just got myself a set Mesa Boogie dual rectifier and an Ibanez baritone guitar. It's like, you know, baritone guitars?
I've heard of them.
Yeah, they're not like, they make for deeper tunings naturally, so they're a little bit bigger scale and stuff. And yeah, I think kicks butt. We had complaints checking them out from the guys above the music store, so I think I can't go wrong.
Yeah, had complaints if it was too loud?
Yeah.
That's nice. And
yeah, I had to be done, man. Had to be done.
That's awesome. Yeah.
You got to check it out under real conditions.
Exactly, yeah. And what do you do when you're not doing Warpath? What have you been doing for your livelihood?
I got my own film production, audio production thing going on called Flint Productions. And I got my other main band. It's like I'm doing the vocals and guitars there. And basically my baby, they're called Razorheads. I'm doing that as well. And that's not enough. I'm working as a technician for concerts, like setting up stages and stuff.
There you go. That's very cool.
And I'm doing film music as well. Like, cooperate with a friend of mine. And that's a total different angle from the rock and roll perspective, but it's kind of funny as well to do the film music thingy there. Because you get told, like, okay, you need like, there you need 15 seconds, and there you need 35 seconds, and it's got to sound like James Bond in the Wild West.
Nice.
Okay.
Very nice.
I had that already. That was the suggestion I had, should sound like James Bond in the Wild West, and I tried, and they took it, and yeah, it's fun. I always like doing that.
That's excellent. And now that Warpath has this new music coming out relatively soon, what is your feeling about the band at this time? Do you think the band is going to be around for years to come? Do you think that you're going to be getting more music out there in the years to come? Do you think that this is the possibility? This is what we're hoping. How do you feel about that?
I would say yes, 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 and yes.
That's excellent. That's good news. You never know.
Yeah, it's a real good vibe in the band now, and we can't wait to play some new stuff live, and especially since the Barling Festival, which was a huge one, big stage, great sound, everything looked perfect, and we're all pretty fired up since then, and can't wait to continue.
Excellent.
The vibe's pretty brilliant now. Yeah.
That's what I wanted to hear. Great news. And Flint, is there right. anything that you would like to say to your fans that are tuning in tonight? You could say anything that you'd like at this time.
Yeah, please come to the shows, check out our video, share it. It's gonna be killer. And yeah, we'll hope to see you all live, because that's where it counts. So it's not Facebook likes or whatever. It's like it's the pit that matters.
Absolutely.
So to say. Hope to see all these guys live, and it's going to be killer.
It sure is. I would love to see you live at some point. And I have to say, Flint, I've really enjoyed our conversation and the opportunity to get to know you. And thank you, and for the opportunity to get to know you better. Before we go and crank up more Warpath, I just want to make sure that we got all the fans up to speed. That being said, is there anything that you would like to say or mention to the people listening that we have yet to discuss? Because I want to make sure that we covered all the bases.
I would say, like, you covered them pretty well.
I tried.
You covered them pretty well. I would just say, show up at live concerts, and that's the most important thing to say.
Absolutely, yes. And
hopefully we'll make it out of Germany sometimes. That would be killer.
That would be killer. So, absolutely, and that would be great to see you in the States.
All right. Yeah. All right, you're welcome.
Yeah. I want to thank you again, Flint, for this interview, and I wish you and all in Warpath a very successful 2017. I hope that Massacre does the right thing by you and you can stay with them for years to come and be bringing us more great albums and offerings in all future years.
Thanks, man.
You can come back to this show anytime. When you have new music and you want to talk about it, you'll always have a home here on the Metal Meltdown on Metal Messiah Radio.
Yeah, I keep stalking you.
I'll be here. I appreciate that.
Sure.
Yeah, it is true. Yeah. So, how about we go crank up some more Warpath, something off the Bullets offering?
Yeah, go ahead. Crank it.
Crank it up, Metal Maniacs.